48 hours, I saw my hometown bombed and my childhood mosque investigated. I've been accused of plotting against my country. I've been mentally and physically harassed. That alone is bad enough. But the worst thing is the grief my own colleagues and countrymen gave me, not just about my donation, but about why I won't say more to defend myself. So here it is, the big reveal, the answer to what you've all been wondering. Of course, I'm just as horrified as everyone that a deranged man blew up a coffee shop. I mean, how could anyone ever doubt that? But I'm not saying anything, publicly or otherwise, because I shouldn't have to. My condemnation should just be a given. When a white man shoots up a black church, no one demands that white men across the country denounce the attack. It's understood that the perpetrator is on the fringe, that every American decries the tragedy. But somehow, when an Islamic extremist commits an atrocity, every Muslim is implicated. All my years of public service, every ounce of decency I've ever shown, is erased by other people's fear and revenge. I mean, do you want to know what my donation to the mosque was earmarked for? A playground for children of the members. And do you want to know what they unveiled last month? A playground.